And let's now shift focus to the other big story that we're tracking here on headlines today. The Central Bureau of Investigation has told the Supreme Court that it has no alternative but to close investigations into the Aircel Maxis deal because there is an extremely powerful lobby in Malaysia. There are elements in the Malaysian government that refuse to share more information with the government, and the probe has hit a dead end in Malaysia. And that's a very, very telling comment made by the CBI in Supreme Court. The comment was made in a sealed cover. The CBI submitted its report to the Supreme Court in a sealed cover. The two judges perused that report. And this is extremely disheartening for the CBI. The question is this being done to help that man you see on your television screen, Dayanidhi Maran, escaped the CBI net? We'll get you more on this big story on the Aircel Maxis deal, because the CBI has investigated this deal within India. The CBI admits that all is not above board. The role of Dayanidhi Maran is in question here, but clearly the CBI has reached a dead end. At least that is what they are saying in the Supreme Court. Now, even in the Supreme Court, prima facie, is there a nexus? And that is the big question. That question has been raised even in the Apex Court. And headlines today's Achal Anand joins me for more on this story. Achal, even the Supreme Court has raised this question that the CBI probe into allegations in this Aircel Maxis deal prima facie indicates a nexus. Take us through the details. What did the bench comprising Justice G.S. Singhvi and Justice K.S. Radhakrishnan say after they perused the report, which was filed in a sealed cover?
Gaurav, it's a very interesting development, because yesterday itself, court made it very clear and said it in so many words that from whatever we have perused so far, whatever is the investigation which has been submitted to the court, done so far by the CBI, it's very clear that there exists a prima facie nexus. Now, the next point is that CBI very categorically yesterday also and today also, it reiterated that they have done the Indian leg of investigation, that is finished, but then they need some information from Malaysia. Obviously, we know the background and how it was going. Very clearly, CBI has been saying this also, that the Malaysian government is not cooperating to that extent, because the person here involved is economically and politically very powerful. So, be that as it may, and it's a background, but at the same time, CBI today hinted, dropped a hint probably, saying when the court was again and again saying that prima facie we do have the proof and it's very clear that there exists a nexus, CBI said we cannot establish a quid pro quo till the time we clearly establish the link of how the money got transferred, how the quid pro quo is linked directly to the beneficiary and the then telecom minister Dayanidhi Maran, and went on to the extent of saying that if we don't prove this, then obviously it will be thrown out by the court and we may have to file the closure report. All of a sudden, in court, which is full of lawyers, yes, if CBI goes about saying that we may have to file a closure report, we won't go beyond this because the matter is sub judice, Gaurav. But CBI saying that, the premier investigating agency, all of, yes, a sudden conceding that in the court, we can well imagine the ramifications of it all.
Indeed. And is the CBI doing this? And that's the big question. Is the CBI doing this at the behest of the government of India? And that is why allegations that the CBI is a handmaiden of the government, because clearly government of India wields enough clout in the region to request the Malaysian government to cooperate in this matter. Clearly Malaysian government would not want to hide criminals in their country, though, when the Supreme Court of India says that prima facie there is evidence of a nexus, Achal.
Gaurav, let me put it this way. CBI is the premier investigative agency. It has always claimed to be an independent investigative agency. But everybody knows that, you know, how the affidavits are virtually, you know, a U-turn is taken the minute the government changes, the stands change. So we won't get into that because let's put it like this, that when the report is submitted in sealed cover, only excerpts and part of it are read in the court. So whatever was the exchange happening between the CBI and the Supreme Court, clearly Supreme Court was trying to tell the CBI that prima facie case does exist and the nexus is established. CBI counsel, senior counsel Mr. K.K. Venugopal, who appeared for CBI, went to the extent of saying that, yes, my learned friends, everybody around wants us to jump the gun, but we cannot do that. And the court made it very clear that, yes, we also don't want you to jump the gun, but at the same time, you cannot take an indefinite time. So, be that as it may, as far as Malaysian government, you said, Gaurav, since we don't have the details of the sealed cover report, but this was very much apparent in the court today okay. also and yesterday also, when CBI said
yes.
that Malaysian government instead had asked what is the evidence against Anant Krishnan.
Yes.
Now, CBI stand is that at this stage, how can we divulge what is the evidence against him? So,
yes.
CBI
really,
was fine
stay
to,
with me for
yes.
a moment. Stay with me, Achal. Let me quickly bring in former CBI director, Mr. Joginder Singh at this stage. Mr. Singh, you have headed the CBI. Is the CBI powerless to take the investigations to its logical conclusion and then submit in a sealed cover in Supreme Court that they are getting no cooperation from the Malaysian government? So, they cannot take the investigations to its logical conclusion, sir.
No, they will not. They will wait it. They will keep on trying it. We don't give up because once you don't get the cooperation, it will be taken up at the minister's level, then higher level. I am sure Malaysia will cooperate. Of course, it is a bad issue. I am not exercising controversy. But we don't give up that easily. There is Interpol also, of which Malaysia is a member, so they are bound to cooperate. There is a position at present, but it may not remain for all times to come. So, I can understand the anxiety of people to see that people are guilty, people are brought to book. But the fact remains here, every country has its own laws, its own approach. And there are people who contribute to the various political parties. They like to get the return back from the government of the day. So,
indeed, and that's here. A very valid point that you've raised, Mr. Joginder, saying that the CBI then can escalate this matter, whether it's at the level of the Interpol or it's at the level of Government of India, perhaps the Ministry of External Affairs, can reach out to their counterparts in Malaysia and request them to take the investigations to its logical conclusion. Is the CBI in this matter then, sir, not appearing to not act independently, sir?
It is not independent. Who said it is independent body? It is not. Because it is not a constituent body like the Election Commission or the CAG or the Supreme Court. So we have to depend on the government for everything. We literally for going to the bathroom also. So there is a position. But I am sure it will not give up that easily.
Okay, that's a very major point that you're making, Mr. Joginder Singh. For the moment, many thanks for joining me here on Headlines Today. We'll track the story very closely. I'd also like to thank my colleague Achal Anand for joining us with those details. Joginder Singh, former director of the CBI, made a very important point. The CBI is not independent even to go to the bathroom. And even though he may have said this in the lighter vein, even to go to the bathroom, CBI needs to take permission from the government. So can the CBI stance be taken as an independent stance? Let me bring in senior advocate Majid Memon for more on this story. Mr. Memon, what do you make of the CBI submitting in Supreme Court that Malaysia is not cooperating, we cannot take this investigation forward?
You know, whether it is CBI or even the highest court of our country, you know, we have our own limitations, we have our own constraints. The law which applies throughout India does not extend outside India. After all, CBI is a national premier investigating agency, but as far as across the border to any other country investigation is concerned, certainly it has to abide by various international norms and international laws. Now, only with the assistance of Interpol that CBI can penetrate into any investigative activity beyond Indian territory. So if they have gone to Malaysia and if Malaysian government within their own framework of laws does not permit a certain thing to have access to, then CBI would be helpless.
Okay, but the question remains, did the CBI explore the Interpol option? Is the CBI independent to explore the Interpol option? We'll track that story very closely. Mr. Majid Maimon, many thanks for joining me here on Headlines Today.